Hi, my name is Paul Zawaska with Beacon Athletics. Today we're going to be burying a brand new Bulldog home plate. These are brand new on the market right now. They're a solid rubber home plate, and they're two-sided. If you take a look at it, you've got your normal home plate on the top here, but if we flip it over, you'll see it's another home plate. So as the top portion wears and you decide you want to replace it, you can take it and just flip it over and put the other side back up again. These are solid rubber, 40 pounds of it. This is not going to buckle. That's the problem that we've seen with a lot of these burial home plates like you've seen in the past that have the waffle on the underside. You get in and you bury these in the ground, and especially in the northern climates where you get a lot of frost, they'll tend to heave these up and cause the corners to cup up and the middle to become concave. And consequently, it becomes a giant dish, and that creates a real problem. What we've done here in the past over here at our Little League complex is we've taken the regular 1-inch thick home plates, and we've built a wood block underneath here, and we actually nail these or screw these to the wood block. But today we're going to replace this one with this brand new Bulldog home plate and give it a test and see how well it works. So let's get to work. All right, so the first thing we have to do is orient how our plate is currently laid out. So we set up our string lines from first and third base, so that they're lining up right along the white edges of the home plate here. And once we've got that set up, then we'll pull those string lines back so they're out of the way, and then we're gonna excavate this home plate out of here and get ready to set the new plate in. So I'm gonna pull these strings out of the way since the string lines were all set up. And we'll do a little demo. Now the other thing I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna try and dig around the front edges of this and stay somewhat away from the back corner, and hopefully I can pull this plate out so that the point stays intact. That'll make it hopefully a little more easier to make sure that home plate gets lined up in the right place. The three sides excavated, this baby's about ready to budge, so I'm gonna get my digging bar underneath here, hopefully be able to just pop this right up carefully. Trying not to disturb the pointed side there too much. Slide that out. There you see our wood block that we made. It was just three layers of wood here using 2x material. And then what we did is we nailed a home plate onto, or screwed a home plate onto the top of this, going through the block for our screws. So that if I wanted to change that out with just another one of these, all I would have had to do was expose the block to get at the screws, unscrew that plate off of there and put a new one on top. But in this situation, we're putting a new one in that we can completely bury. So we'll take this home plate, get it out of the way, and prepare our hole for the other home plate. All right, so we're getting ready to plant our new Bulldog home plate. Now, since this is a two-sided home plate, I don't want the underside of that to get stained in any way by soil. And since this hole is already too deep because of our wood block, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use some of this limestone screenings here to bring up the level that we need to for the base of this. But by using the stone also, I've got a lot less chance of that stone on the underside staining this the bottom face of the home plate in case I ever want to use it again. So we're going to go ahead and drop a bunch of this in here, spread it out. Notice we've got our nice sides here where the home plate originally was. And that doesn't guarantee that the home plate's going to be in the right spot, but it's going to give me a good place to start. Spread out, and then we'll compact it and we'll see how we're doing on depth. It looks like I might need a little bit more in here. Probably have to get another bag. Thank you.
up this in again and check it with the torpedo level, which is fine because I've probably got to, actually, I'm just about right here.
So,
I'm going to clear the way for these
string lines to go back in place. I'm going to clear a little bit of spoils out of the way here. String lines back. Put the underside down first. Now we'll have some room to work with. Now before I do anything, double check and make sure we haven't affected the levelness. Side to side, we're still good. What's your shadow? Front to back, still pretty good. Okay, so now we've got to adjust these plate. Now it's too far in, which is fine. We're going to take this now, we'll use the side knife as a lever just to kind of loosen this out, get it in line. Pretty good. Looking over from the top, right at the point down, looks like we're right on that edge as you take a look. That's where we want to be. Now the last thing we have to do is we have to check our measurements. We'll check our base measurements from first to third base, back corners, down to the front point. This is a 90-foot diamond, so this should be 90-foot bases. So we should be able to measure from this point all the way to the back of each of those bases. And then we'll do one last check out to the mound and make sure that we're 60 feet 6 inches to the pitch. Okay, so we're at the back of first base here. I'm going to put this right at the back corner of first base. Set that in. And we'll check our measurement.
Right on the money.
See here, we're right at the money at 90 feet, just like it should be. All right, now we'll check our 90 from third base. Hopefully, everything will be just right. Oh, my name is Mud. Once again, we're right on the money, 90 feet. All right, so now we know that the bases are correct. Last thing we gotta check is the pitching rubber. Now while we're up on this rubber, we'll give you a little update on some testing we've been doing. This is the new Bulldog almost solid pitching rubber, the pitching block, the 6x24 adult one. These new ones have a lot more rubber in them with a very small bore in the center. Now what that does is that stops this pitching rubber from bubbling. You'll notice this has been in here now for a year and a half. Over 600 events already on this field since this has gone in. Evenly divided between metal spike games and rubber spike games. So you'll see just a little bit of wear on here, not much, but probably more important than anything else, and if my cameraman can get down low with this rubber, you'll be able to see as you look across here that it's nice and flat. We don't have any bubble in there. A common problem with a lot of pitching rubbers is that bubble, and it's because in most of those cases those rubbers don't have enough thickness of rubber along the top there to stop that from being bubbled. What happens, they bubble from either the pitcher's pushing off of that rubber, or when you're tamping clamp against here, the force can push that rubber to bubble as well. All right, these new Bulldog rubbers have not shown that they will ever have that problem. This is nice and tight. If I had a normal rubber in here, we can't get by with more than a year before we have to replace it because of that bubble in the rubber. These are well worth the money that you pay for them because you don't have to replace them anywhere near as often. That's savings in labor, that's savings in pitching rubbers. Again, there's a higher upfront cost, but they're gonna last you a lot longer period of time. And it's more likely that you're gonna be able to turn these without having any problem. Whereas the other ones, when they bubble and you try and turn them, they get real hard to level and things like that. These stay nice and flat. All right, so we gotta take our measurement now
down to home plate. I'm going to put my pin here right up against the front edge of the pitching rubber in the center. And if everything's working for me, and all the planets align, it should be 60 feet, 6 inches to home plate. Pile of soil out of the way here, obviously. Otherwise, I'm going to skew my reading because it'll make the tape go up over the top of that hill. Short, actually. We're about 60 feet 5 and 3 quarters inches instead of 60 feet 6 inches. I could probably cheat that a little bit. Can't cheat it too much. I can take my sod knife and just push this ever so slightly forward. I got to push this out just a little bit. Corner there. This may adjust our base measurements just a smidge. And we gain ourselves about an eighth of an inch. I really don't want to go any farther than that. In Little League, an eighth of an inch, that's pretty darn good. So that's what we're going to stick with. So we're ready to bury this home plate now. So what we're going to do is we're going to get our clay set in here. I don't want to move the strings yet in case this thing ends up moving on us. But I do want to get some moisture in here before I put the clay in. And the trick is going to be to pack that clay in without moving this plate. So we leave these string lines up for reference. It's nice and wet in here. So that clay bonds. All right. I'm gonna stand on home plate so hopefully the weight of my body will keep it from moving. And judging from what it was at the doctor's the other day, I'm sure my weight will pretty much keep it still. Before we get too far, double check our level, make sure nothing's changed. By the way, one of the nice things about these new Bulldog home plates, smooth surface on the top. A lot of the home plates that are out there right now have a texture on here. A lot of people that don't like that because the dirt gets caught in that texture, but on these Bulldog home plates, they're nice and smooth. So we're good side to side. We're a little off. Front to back, we're a little high in the front. So we're going to take our tamp, give it a little wail. And we'll see if that adjusted. Look at that. All right, in place. Still good there. I'm going to give it one more little tamp. There you go. We're within the lines. So, just finish up now. I'm going to add some more water to this clay that I put in.
put the top layer on and get it all buried, and she'll be all finished. All right, just a second. Okay, so we're all set. We've got the Bulldog home plate planted in the ground. Everything's been aligned, as you saw here. Measurements are all correct. We've got the home plate level. So here she'll sit, and we'll check back in on about another year, year and a half, like we did the pitching rubber, to see how it's taken the wear and the wear and tear. But I guarantee you, this home plate, because of the way it's built with that solid rubber, there is no way that the frost is going to curl this rubber up. And that's the big benefit to this. That plus the fact that you can actually turn this home plate and use the other side. Again, it's a more expensive home plate than most home plates, but it's more durable, higher quality, more rubber in it. It's not gonna bend and contort. In the long haul, this is gonna save you money in the long haul because of the labor savings of changing home plates out more frequently. So let's check back in about another year and a half.